I recently made a video about what MIP mapping is and how it works, so I thought I'd do a follow-up video on how to actually MIP map textures for all the games in the GTA trilogy. If you haven't watched my video on MIP mapping, I'd highly suggest doing so before following this tutorial. Knowing how to MIP map textures is useful, especially if you use older mods that maybe don't have MIP maps, and you'd like to add them yourself. Before we begin, you're going to need Magic.txt. If you use any other TXT editor, I'd recommend you no longer use them as they're likely outdated. Magic.txt has every feature you'd ever want and supports all the formats you'll ever need. I'll leave a link to Magic.txt in the description. For Vice City, MIP maps don't actually work by default. You'll need DK's Voice MIPS ASI plugin in order for MIP maps to work. I'll leave a link in the description. Make sure you have an ASI loader and put the plugin and its configuration file inside your Vice City folder. Okay, let's move on to the tutorial. If you're MIP mapping a single texture, it's really simple. Drag the TXT archive into Magic.txt. You can also use the open menu instead if that's what you prefer. Find the texture you want to MIP map. In this case, I'm going to use the train track texture that I used in my last video. As you can see here, it says level 1. This basically means that the texture has no MIP maps. Once you have the texture highlighted, click Edit, then click Setup MIP Levels. The level value will now change, indicating the texture now contains MIP maps. In this case, 11 MIP levels. Magic.txt will assign the correct number of MIP levels depending on the texture's resolution. And that's it, the texture is now MIP mapped. Don't forget to save before exiting Magic.txt. If you want to remove MIP maps from a texture, repeat this process, except this time click Clear MIP Levels instead of Setup MIP Levels. If you want to add or replace a texture with another and also give it MIP maps, you can do this in the Add or Replace Texture window. For example, if I want to replace this texture with a higher quality texture, all I have to do is click Edit, then Replace, and then in the Replace window, make sure Generate MIP Maps is ticked, and then click Replace. The same applies when adding a new texture to a TXT archive. Okay, so what if you want to MIP map multiple textures at the same time? Magic.txt makes this very easy. So on my desktop, I've made an A folder and a B folder. In the A folder, we have two TXT archives and an IMG archive. The TXT archives have no MIP maps. I've went back and cleared all the MIP maps in this one. As you can see, one level, one level, one level. And in this TXT archive, also no MIP maps. One level, one level, one level. Now, if you've modded GTA before, you know most of the TXT archives in the game are actually stored in IMG archives. So this is a cool feature of Magic.txt. In this IMG archive, there are plenty of textures, and I've cleared them all of MIP maps. So just to show you, here's a TXT archive here. We're going to export this to our desktop. And as you can see, no MIP maps. One level, one level, one level, one level. No MIP maps on any of these textures. This applies to all these TXT archives in this IMG archive. So, let's go back to Magic.txt. Oh, sorry, we also have the B folder, and this contains nothing. So, let's go back to Magic.txt. Open Tools and open Mask Convert. So, you have two folders that you have to select. You have your Game Root folder and your Output Root folder. My Game Root folder is the A folder on my desktop. This is where you want the textures that haven't got MIP maps to be that you want MIP mapped. Output root is where you want the new files to be generated with your MIP maps. So in that case, it's the B folder on my desktop. Platform, PC, game, GTA SA, but you can also pick Vice City or GTA 3. Clear MIP maps, this makes no difference because we're going to generate MIP maps anyway. Generate MIP maps, we want this on, make sure this box is ticked. The max value, since this is a mask conversion, you're better off just leaving this value at 11 or 12. Improve filtering, leave this on. Compress textures, again, unless you really know what you're doing, I'd recommend leaving this on. and reconstruct IMG archives. You're best leaving this on too, unless you know what you're doing. Once you have all these set this way, you can basically hit convert, and now this will mipmap all the TXT archives in the IMG archive and also mipmap the TXT archives that we also have in the A folder. Okay, now that it's done, we can go to our B folder, and as you can see, we now have two of the same TXT archives that we found in the A folder, and we also have the IMG archive. If we take a look in the TXT archives, as you can see, they all the textures have mipmaps in this TXT archive. Level 8, level 8, level 7, level 8, our train track texture, 11 levels, the other TXT archive, 10 levels, 8 levels, 10 levels. And now the cool thing is, the IMG archive also has all the textures mipmapped. So let's go into this. The DFF files are also all here, the model files, the collision files. Let's get the same TXT file that we had before. We'll export this. It's going to overwrite the TXT archive on the desktop. Open it. And as you can see, 8 levels, 8 levels, 9 levels, 9 levels, all mipmapped. So that's a quick and easy way to mipmap all the textures in IMG archives and TXT archives outside of the IMG archives. Anyway, that's all for this video. If you found this tutorial helpful, be sure to give the video a like. And don't forget to check out the channel for more modding videos like this.